In part two of our lesson on linear and angular speed, you're going to learn how to solve word problems involving angular speed and linear speed. In this first example, we're told that a wheel rotates at a rate of pi over 24 radians per minute. So the first thing that you want to think about is that radians per minute must be a unit of omega. So we know that omega is equal to pi over 24 radians per minute. Now we know that we can also write that as pi over 24 per minute, which is the same thing as writing pi over 24 minutes. So saying pi over 24 radians per minute is the same thing as saying pi over 24 minutes when you simplify it. The problem asks us how long, well, we stop right there because how long means it's asking us to find t. So how long will it take the wheel to rotate through 3 pi over 8 radians? Now the only variable that has units of radians is theta. So we know theta is 3 pi over 8 radians, which we're allowed to write simply as 3 pi over 8. Now we're looking for an equation to use to solve this problem. We have the variable omega, we have the variable theta, and we have the variable t involved. So we know we have an equation that omega is equal to theta over t. Now we know we're going to be solving for t, so we might want to just go ahead and get t out of the denominator. So we can take the t, cross multiply it up to the left hand side, and simultaneously take the omega and cross multiply it down to the right hand side, and we get that t is going to equal theta divided by omega. And now we can plug in the values that we have. We know theta was given to us as 3 pi over 8. Omega is pi over 24 minutes. We know that we're going to multiply by the reciprocal of the denominator, so we get 3 pi over 8 times 24 minutes over pi, and we see that we're going to get t is equal to, well, let's see, we know that the pi in the numerator is going to cancel with the pi in the denominator. We also know that 8 will go into 24 three times. So we're left with t is equal to 9, and the units are minutes. So the units make sense. We know that we should have ended up with units of time. So it will take the wheel 9 minutes to rotate through an angle of 3 pi over 8 when it's rotating at a rate of pi over 24 radians per minute. Now, since this is a word problem, we should give our answer in a sentence. So you could say something simple like, it will take the wheel 9 minutes to rotate through an angle of 3 pi over 8 radians. Something along those lines. Anything along those lines will work. In this next example, we're told we have a belt is attached to a pulley whose radius is 5 centimeters and rotates at 30 RPM. So the blue line here is the belt. The circle represents the pulley, and the belt is going around the pulley. Now we're told that the radius of the pulley is 5 centimeters, so we can get that going in our drawing. We know the radius is equal to 5 centimeters. We're also told that the pulley rotates at 30 RPM, which we know is revolutions per minute. And if you remember from an earlier lesson, we know that that is a version of omega. So omega is equal to 30 revolutions per minute. Now we're being asked to find the angular speed of the pulley in radians per second and the linear speed of the belt in centimeters per second. Okay. Right now omega is in revolutions per minute. We need to get it into radians per second, so we're going to need to use conversion factors. Now, to get rid of the revolutions, we know we're going to want to put one revolution in the denominator. We know that we need radians in the numerator, and one revolution is 2 pi radians. So now the revolutions in the denominator are going to cancel out the revolutions in the numerator. And if we stopped right now, the units of our answer would be radians per minute. We know we need radians per second, so we have to keep going here. We're going to use another conversion factor, and we can say that 1 minute is equivalent to 60 seconds. We know we want to put the 1 minute in the numerator because we want it to cancel with the 1 minute that is in the denominator. So that's going to happen. The minute down here will cancel with the minute that's up here. Now we have 30 times 2 in the numerator, which is 60, and that's going to cancel the 60 that's down here in the denominator. So the only thing we're going to have left is pi, and our units are radians per second, and we know that we can write that as pi per second. And in fact, we're going to want to write it that way when we carry on to find the linear speed. Now v, we know, is r times omega. R is 5 centimeters. Omega is pi per second. So that means that V is going to equal 5 pi centimeters per second. So we have omega, and we have V, and we need to write our answer as a sentence. So we can say the angular speed of the pulley is pi per second, and the linear speed of the belt is 5 pi centimeters per second. So physically, what's happening here is if you were standing at the center of the pulley and you were turning to keep up with a point traveling on the circle of the pulley, you would have to be turning at a rate of pi every second. So in other words, halfway around every second. Now, v, the linear speed, is 5 pi centimeters per second. So that means a point on the belt is traveling at 5 pi centimeters every second. So as it goes around the pulley, the speed of that, if it was in a little car, the car would be registering 5 pi centimeters per second on its speedometer. Now we know pi is roughly close to 3, it's the closest whole number, so just to have a ballpark idea, this thing is moving about 15 centimeters every second. In this next example, we are being asked to find the linear speed of a point. Well, before I go any farther, let's think about that. Find the linear speed. We know that means we have to find v, and the point is on the end of the minute hand of a clock. And then we have to find v in units of inches per minute. Now we're told that the length of the minute hand is 12 inches. So if we draw the minute hand on here, we know that it is 12 inches. We need to take stock of what it is we know and what it is we have to find. Now the point lives on the end of the minute hand. So the point is out here on the end of the minute hand. And as the minute hand travels around, so will that point. And we have to find its linear speed. Now, think about the minute hand. You know, maybe picture like 3 o'clock. At 3 o'clock, we know the minute hand is on the 12, and then at 3:05, it's here, and at 3:10, it's here, at 3:15, 3:30, 3:45, 4 o'clock. So it takes an hour for this thing to go all the way around. Now, we know that the equation for v is that v is equal to r times omega. Now r, we can see we actually already have. R is the length of that minute hand. So r is equal to 12 inches. So we need omega. We know omega is equal to theta over t, and we just said that we know that this minute hand will make one revolution in an hour. Now, we know our units of time are going to have to be minutes, so we know this thing makes one revolution in 60 minutes, so we can let t be 60 minutes. Put that in our equation. Now, the last thing we need is theta. Now, we know that the minute hand is going to go all the way around in 60 minutes, so we know that means theta is going to have to be 2 pi. So we can plug that into our equation. And we see that when we reduce here, 2 goes into 60 30 times, we're going to get pi over 30 per minute. Now remember, if you had put in 2 pi radians, then this would be 2 pi radians, and this would be pi over 30 radians per minute, which you can write as pi over 30 per minute. Now we take omega and plug it into the linear speed equation. We know r is 12 inches. Omega is pi over 30 per minute. We know that 12 and 30 have a common factor of 6. So 12 divided by 6 is 2. 30 divided by 6 is 5. So this becomes 2 pi over 5 inches per minute. And now we're ready to write our answer in the form of a sentence. So we could say something like, the point on the end of the minute hand has a linear speed of 2 pi over 5 inches per minute.